Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you exactly what's happening, what's going wrong, why I can't install Windows 7 and why the system's just not doing what I want it to be doing, which is obviously installing Windows 7. And hopefully you guys can watch this video and just let me know where I'm going wrong, because I find it very difficult to explain things. So I thought, because I don't even know what's going on myself. I don't know why it's not installing, so I can't explain it if I don't know myself. So that's why I've decided to make a video, just to let you guys know, you know, what's going on, so you can see for yourself live here. So anyway, here we are at the installing window screen, and as you can see, it's nearly finished doing the expanding. I obviously didn't want to start it from the beginning because it would be a long video and I wouldn't want to be talking too much. So I'm going to take you through exactly what's going on here and what it's going to be doing. I mean, once it's done this, it's obviously going to install features, updates, and it's just going to try and complete the installation like it usually does. It shouldn't take too long now. I apologise if this video has a lot of me talking, but okay, so it does all this fine. All of this gets done correctly. We're installing the updates now, yep. And then it's going to do its simple restarting method. I can just restart it manually. By the way, this is what my computer looks like, if you didn't see the last video of me actually fixing it. It's hard to see in the dark, the light in here is no good, but yeah, that's it basically. That's what it does. Yeah, that's the trouble I'm having with it at the moment. I'll also show you a blue screen message which pops up now and again. I have no idea or no clue what that message means, but again, hopefully you guys can help me with that. Right, so, I mean, it does everything fine here. It starts Windows correctly here, you know. It's not my hard drive. I thought it was my hard drive months ago that was causing this problem, but I recently bought a new hard drive and the new hard drive's in there right now and it's currently installing on it and it still doesn't work, so it can't be the hard drive. I think what it's going to do is it's just going to restart itself several times before it actually freezes at the bit where I'm going to show you in a minute. Again, sorry for the length of this video. This video is going to be quite lengthy. But, you know, obviously, please watch, please help and support, because I've been having a lot of trouble with this. Okay. So, it gets past this part okay. And as you can see, everything's done here, completing installation. And I think what it's going to do is it's going to restart itself again in a minute. I've also tried this on a USB thumb drive, it does the same thing. I've got the official Windows disk. So again, it's not the disk that's causing any problems. Because I installed this on my friend's computer and it just worked like a charm. But with this one, I don't know. I've had Windows 7 on here before, but I had to unfortunately take it off because I had a nasty virus on my computer. Yep, that's what viruses do. Always keep your computer clean. Because if it weren't for that virus, I wouldn't be doing none of this right now. I'd still have Windows 7 on there. Okay, and I think we're at the bit where I'm having the problem at now. So, right, and this is the problem that I'm having. This is the main problem right at this bit. This little blinker here flashes. I mean, it's supposed to only flash for 3 seconds and then carry on what it's supposed to be doing. But as you can see, nothing's happening. It's just blinking, and you know, if I was to leave this hanging like this right now for about 15 minutes, obviously I'm not going to do that because, you know, it'll be too long with the video. But what this will do, after about 10 minutes of doing this, it would just blue screen. That blue screen message, I have no idea what it is, because it would just quickly restart the computer after about 1 or 2 seconds, not giving me a chance to read it. So this is what it's doing. This is the problem, the main problem I'm having. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to obviously shut down my computer now, because it's going to force me to shut it down now. And then we're going to start it up again, and I'm going to show you what happens next. So yeah, that's the first problem I'm having. That's where it gets stuck. That is the first pathway of the problem, and that happens every single time. Okay, so it's doing its job for now. Right, and here we have, well, obviously, because I didn't shut the computer down successfully, it's going to do that. So we're going to start Windows normally. So here we are at the splash screen, starting Windows. This is the second problem I'm having. And there you have it, completely frozen, nothing, not moving, not doing anything. The light on my hard drive is not blinking, so that means nothing's happening. It's completely gone, it's completely frozen. And every time I'm going to restart the computer and turn it back on and start Windows normally, this is what happens. I just can't get past it. So let me show you what happens when I restart it, go into the boot options, and start Windows with last known good configuration. Again, really sorry for the length of the video here, but you know, it's got to be done. I've got to show you every single thing what's happening, because I just can't explain it. Because I have no idea. It's really getting to me and it's really stressing me out. You know, I just spent 50 odd quid on a hard drive, and now I'm thinking, you know, what a waste, because I thought it was the actual hard drive that was causing this problem, but obviously not. You know, and this is where you guys can really come in and help me, because I'm really stuck. Like, proper stuck. Right, so here we are at the advanced boot options. Now, I'm going to do this last known good configuration. Now, look what happens when I do this. This is the third problem. It will pass the starting Windows screen. Or will it? It usually does. No, it is supposed to... Okay. I get this little thing in the corner here, which I don't know what that is. And lo and behold... That was a quick blue screen of death message, which obviously you didn't see because it was so quick. But there you go. And it just restarts my computer. Now I'm going to show you that blue screen of death message by disabling the thing that says don't shut down the computer on a crash or whatever it's called. I know what it's called. So I'm just going to do that. The wrong thing here. Right. Disable automatic restart on system failure. That's the one. Okay, now you'll be able to see the blue screen of death message. Now, as from this part onwards, whether I turn the computer on, switch it off, power it on or off. This is what's going to happen all the time now. It's going to not freeze at starting Windows. It's going to bypass the starting Windows. But it's going to keep doing this awful blue screen reboot loop. And that's because I've obviously done last known good configuration. If I didn't press last known good configuration, it would just hang at the Windows screen. So here we are. It's about to blue screen, and I know it's about to blue screen because this little green light here is in the corner. And there we have it. Blue screen of death. Now there's the message right there. Half of it has come off the screen, but there's the message right there. And obviously if I was to turn the computer off, it would just do this over and over again, forcing me to reinstall and see if it works again, which obviously is not going to work. So there you go, guys. This is the problem I'm having with installing Windows 7. Quite a lengthy video, but any help would be greatly appreciated. Hopefully I'll be able to resolve this tonight. But I'm going to post this up from my Wi-Fi on my phone, and hopefully you guys can, I'll tag a few of you guys in and you can hopefully see what's going on with this, because it's awful. But anyway, thanks for watching this video. And obviously once again, thanks for all your help and support, and I will see you all soon.